Good morning, students. Today I want to start a new lesson, which is named as a nuclei. 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 What is a nuclei? What is a nucleus? Let us discuss. Let us take any substance. We know which is a composed of an atoms. Any substance which is a composed of an atoms. Suppose if you take the nucleus of atom, let it be like this. The central massive part is said to be nucleus. Nucleus having a protons and neutrons. Around this nucleus, particular orbits are there. Their electrons are revolving in that particular orbits. So here we want to discuss about this nucleus. What is a nucleus? The central massive part of a nucleus, the central massive part of atom, is said to be nucleus, which are having the protons and neutrons. Nucleus having protons and neutrons. Where the protons having a positive charge and neutron possess a neutral charge, means no charge. Neutral charge means it's a no charge. So the entire nucleus having the positive charge because of the protons. So the entire nucleus having the positive charge. Why? Because the protons having positive charge and the neutrons having neutral charge. So that the nucleus attains the charge of the proton, so it becomes a positive charge. So the protons and neutrons are commonly known as nucleons. What is meant by nucleon? Nucleon means nucleons. Nucleons means the protons and neutrons are collectively known as nucleons. What are meant by nucleons? Nucleon means the protons and neutrons are collectively known as nucleons. So nucleons means the protons and the neutrons are said to be nucleons. In this lesson, nuclei, nuclei means is a plural form of nucleus. Nucleus is a singular and nuclei means is a plural form. This carries 8 marks in our IPE. Let it be question number 21st. Definite question, which is the most important lesson. So this is the combination of the protons and neutrons such as a nucleus. So in this lesson especially, we discuss about these nucleons, means protons and neutrons. We know the protons are invented by Rutherford and neutrons by J.J. Thomson. Protons are invented by Rutherford, the neutrons are invented by J.J. Thomson. So in this lesson, we are going to discuss about these protons and neutrons especially. Now we discuss about how we represent a nuclei or a nucleus. How we represent a nucleus? Representation of a nucleus. How we are represented? We are represented by using a notation Z, X, A, or we can write it as Z, X, A. Like this. We are using a special notation to represent a nucleus, ZXA, or we can write it as ZXA. We keep this A either left side or right side, wherever it is. It is a new notation. Nowadays they are writing like this. In old notation they are writing like this, ZXA. This is the example. How can you write like, we want to write about helium, we can write like this, 2He4. Suppose carbon, let it be carbon, 6C12. Let it be nitrogen, 7 nitrogen 14. This is a representation of a nucleus. By seeing this notation, we can easily identify that how many, what is that element, how many number of electrons are there, and how many number of protons there, and how many number of neutrons are there. Now, by using simply, we can see this notation, we can identify. Okay, identify where here it is. Z is said to be atomic number. Z is said to be atomic number. Z is also said to be atomic number. Atomic number, what it represents? It represents the number of protons. This gives information about the number of protons inside the nucleus is equals to the number of electrons outside the nucleus. The atomic number gives the information regarding the number of protons inside the nucleus. Which number is equal to the number of electrons which are present outside the nucleus. Got it? Next, where X is an element. Where X is element. We know the elements like hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminum, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium, like this. These are all elements are represented by the notation X. And where A is said to be mass number. Where A is said to be mass number. Mass number represents the number of protons plus number of neutrons. The total nucleons number which gives by mass number. Mass number gives the information about the total number of nucleons. The number of protons plus number of neutrons. But A minus Z gives information about the number of neutrons. Look at here. Once again, I can explain this representation of a nucleus. Nucleus is represented by a special notation. We can write it as ZXA or ZXA. So where Z is said to be atomic number, which gives the information about the number of protons. This number is equal to the number of electrons. Suppose if you take any element or any nuclei, so the number of protons inside the nucleus is equal to the number of electrons outside the nucleus. Next, about X is represented to element, and A is a mass number. Mass number gives the information regarding the number of protons plus number of neutrons. We want to find the number of neutrons. How can we find? A minus Z gives the information about the number of neutrons. A minus Z gives the information about the number of neutrons. Suppose if you take an example, let it be 7 nitrogen 15. Here, what is the element? It is in the form of ZXA. Now, what is the element here? We can easily identify that where N means it's a nitrogen. Element is a nitrogen. Z is equal to 7. What it gives information? Z is equal to 7 means the number of protons. Number of protons is equal to 7 in a similar manner. Number of electrons also 7. We want to find the number of neutrons. Where A is equal to 15. Mass number. A equal to 15 means here it is a mass number. So if you want to find the number of neutrons, simply we can do 15 minus 7, that is equal to 8, which gives the number of neutrons. So, by seeing this notation, we can easily identify what is the element, how many number of electrons are there, and how many number of protons and how many number of neutrons are there. So, the scientists simply, they invented a notation. By seeing this, we can easily identify that what is that element and how many number of nucleons are there. So this is a representation of an element. Yeah, okay, got it? Next we move to next topic. The electron is represented by which symbol? Proton is represented by which symbol? And neutron. Let us know how we represent the what bits. Generally, electron is represented by minus 1 e 0 or minus 1 beta 0. Minus 1 beta 0. And the proton. Proton is represented by 1H1. That is a hydrogen. 1H1 means nothing but hydrogen. And the neutron. Neutron is represented by 0 and 1. 0 and 1. This is a representation. So you have to remember. These elementary particles are represented by the symbols. The electron is represented by minus 1 E0 and the proton is represented by 1H1. 1H means nothing but it's a proton. And neutron is represented by 0 and 1. Neutron is represented by 0 and 1. So, this simple representation. Now, how can we classify the nuclei? Which is important for the 4 months question. Our next topic is classification of nuclei. Classification of nuclei. Classification of nuclei. Classification of nuclei. Nuclei is classified into isotopes, next one is isobars, next one isotones, and last one is isomers. Isotopes, isobars, isotones and isomers. Totally the flow of 4 categories, 4 classifications. Isotopes, isobars, isotones and isomers. Now let us discuss what are isotopes, isotones, isomers and isotopes. First we discuss about isotopes. What are isotopes? The name itself, iso means the similarity. Iso means the same or similarity. The term iso stands for what it represents. What is the meaning of iso? Iso means it's the same, similarity. Isotopes and now I write an example. Okay, example Rasin and explain chestanadi. I can write like this 1H1 and 1H2 and 1H3. These three are said to be hydrogen isotopes. The examples for the isotopes are hydrogen. I consider here hydrogen 1H1, 1H2, 1H3. This is called proton or hydrogen. 1H2 is called deuterium or deutron, and 1H3 is called tritium. 1H3 is called tritium. Look at here 1H1, 1H2, and 1H3. 1H1 is a hydrogen or proton, 1H2 deuterium or deutron, and 1H3 is a tritium. These are all said to be hydrogen isotopes. How can we define isotopes? Here, just you observe, atom is the same atom, hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. The atomic number also same, 1, 1, 1. But the mass numbers are different, 1, 2, 3. How can we define? Now, the atoms of the same elements, look at here carefully. The atoms of the same elements having same atomic number but different mass numbers are called isotopes. What are meant by isotopes? The atoms of the same elements, hydrogen, hydrogen, hydrogen. The atoms of the same elements having same atomic number. This 1, 1, 1 atomic numbers. These are represents. 1, 2, 3 represents the mass numbers. This is an element. The atoms of the same elements having same atomic number but different mass numbers are called isotopes. The atoms. Atoms of the same elements. The atoms of the same elements having same atomic number. Same atomic number but different mass numbers. But different mass numbers. Mass numbers are called isotopes.
So this is over. Once again, listen carefully, friends. What are isotopes?
The atoms of the same elements having same atomic number but different mass numbers are called isotopes. Next, isobars. Next one is isobars. Isobars. I can write an example here. Example is 7 nitrogen 15 and 8 oxygen 15.
Just you observe this. Just you observe this.
Here, the atomic numbers are different. Elements also different. Here it is a nitrogen and it is an oxygen, but mass number is same. But the mass number is same. Here we have a similarity is there. The ISO stands for a similarity. Here one similarity is there. That is the mass number is the same. So let us follow the definition. The atoms of the different elements, not same, different, nitrogen and oxygen. The atoms of the different elements having different atomic numbers but mass number is the same, those are called isobars. Got it? Look at here. The atoms of the different elements having different atomic numbers but mass number is the same are said to be isobars. The atoms of the different elements, not same, different elements having different atomic numbers, but their mass numbers are same. Are called isobars.
Okay. Next, it's isotopes. What are meant by isotopes?
Iso means it's a similar. Tones. What is tones? Let us see. I write an example here. 19 potassium 39 and 20 calcium 40.
Iso means we need a similarity. First we have to identify what is that similarity. Here the atomic numbers are different, elements are different, mass numbers are different. You want one similarity by the definition. Iso means same. You want to find the one similarity. What is that similarity?
Here 13 minus 19 is equal to 20. 40 minus 20 is equal to 20.
The number of neutrons are same. Iso means same. Here what is the same quantity is neutrons. So how can we define the isotopes? The atoms of the different elements having different atomic numbers and mass numbers, but their neutron number is the same. That is isotopes. So look at here. The atoms of the different elements having different atomic numbers and mass numbers, but their neutron number is the same. This is over. So the atoms of the different elements having different atomic and mass numbers, but their neutron number is the same. This is the definition for the isotope. We move on to next topic, isomers. isomers. What is meant by an isomer? Isomer. Here consider an example. 35 bromium 80 and 35 bromium 80. They seems to be both are same, no? So element is a bromium bromium and atomic number 35 and the mass number 88. So we find one difference. All are same, no? So that we find one difference. What is that? Chuda. Let us see the definition for the isomers. The atoms of the same elements having same atomic number and same mass number, but their nuclear properties are different. What are those nuclear properties? Means nuclear radioactivity and nuclear magnetic moment are different. These factors are different for isomers. So look at here. What are isomers? The atoms of the same elements having same atomic and mass numbers, but the nuclear properties like the nuclear radioactivity and nuclear magnetic moment are different. Nuclear magnetic moments are different, right? So once again I can explain these four quantities. First I write an example for isotopes, isobars, isotones and isomers. First isotopes 1H1, 1H2, 1H3 isobars 7 nitrogen 15, 8 oxygen 15. Next isomers 19 potassium 39, 20 calcium 40. Next isomers. So example 35 bromium 80 and this is the 35 bromium 80. Look at here, I can explain in few seconds. The atoms of the same elements having same atomic number but different mass numbers are called isotopes. The atoms of the different elements having different atomic numbers and the same mass number are called isobars. The atoms of the different elements having different atomic and mass numbers but their neutron numbers are same, isomers. The atoms of the same elements having same atomic and mass numbers but their nuclear properties like nuclear radioactivity, all these are different. This is the classification of nuclei, which carries a 4 marks in our IP examination. Okay, students, that's enough for today. We'll meet on next day. Thank you.